JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for September the 22nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against most of the other major currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It lost ground only versus CHF and JPY, while it decked out the most gains versus AUD and CAD. The strengthening of the US dollar and the other safe havens, yen and franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked currencies, suggests that markets may have continued trading in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that major EU indices rebounded, perhaps due to short covering after Monday's steep tumble. That said, appetite was more subdued during the US and Asian sessions, with their respective indices trading mixed. Maybe some investors stayed careful due to the FOMC decision later today, despite Evergrande announcing overnight that it would pay some bond interest due on Thursday. That said, the default risks are far from diminished in our view. They are still well on the table. The developer missed interest payments on Monday to at least two of its largest bank creditors, and the failure to do so within 30 days would put the bond in default. The same could happen to other bonds as well if no solution is found soon. Therefore, we believe that the Evergrande saga may continue being a headache for market participants at least for a while more. Now, as far as the FOMC decision is concerned, this is one of the bigger meetings, which will be accompanied by updated economic projections and a new dot plot. Following the weaker than expected August employment report, market participants scaled back their expectations that the Fed could indeed start tapering its quantitative easing purchases this year. However, a couple of weeks ago, several policymakers signaled that they still expect to begin the process before the end of this year, despite the slowdown in jobs growth seen in August, reviving hopes on that front. What's more, the CPIs for August slowed somewhat but remained well above the Fed's objective of 2%, keeping questions on whether the inflation surge is transitory well on the table. So with all that in mind, it would be interesting to see whether this is the opinion held by the majority of policymakers and whether there will be any strong clues on the possible timing of beginning the tapering process. In our view, anything pointing to a November start may support the US dollar further and perhaps extend the latest setback in equities. Market participants may also be eager to find out whether this could also result in earlier rate hikes. The June dot plot revealed that interest rates are likely to start rising in 2023, with 13 members seeing higher rates through that year and the median dot sitting at 0.6%, which means 2/4-point hikes. However, 7 officials saw at least one hike in 2022, and if that number grows, it could consist of another reason for more USD strengthening and further retreat in stock indices. As according to the yields of the Fed Fund futures, market participants currently expect the first 25 basis point hike to be delivered in April 2023. Ahead of the FOMC decision, during the Asian session today, we had another central bank deciding on monetary policy, and this was the Bank of Japan. This bank kept all its policy settings all its policy settings steady but offered a bleaker view on exports and output, saying that exports and factory output continues to increase although they are partly affected by supply constraints. In July, officials just noted that exports and output continue to increase steadily. In our view, this reinforces the case for the bank to maintain its policy extra loose, even as other major central banks are discussing ways to start scaling back some of their crisis-related support. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides the Fed decision, we also have the US existing home sales for August, which are expected to have slid somewhat, as well as the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. The forecast points to a 1.190 million barrels slide after the 1.688 million decline the week before. However, bearing in mind that the American Petroleum Institute reported a 6.108 million barrels tumble yesterday, we would consider the risk surrounding the EIA number as tilted to the downside. Now, as for the speakers, besides Fed Chair Powell, who will hold a press conference after his bank's decision, we will also get to hear again by ECB Supervisory Board Chair Andrea Enria. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. So goodbye, have a great day. And I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.